Let's move on to the second part. Now we introduce the Robbins-Monroe algorithm, which is a classic algorithm in stochastic approximation theory. After learning this algorithm, you will find that it is very simple, powerful, and elegant. Why? Let's take a look. We have repeatedly mentioned stochastic approximation so far. What exactly is it? First, it is abbreviated as SA and refers to a broad class of stochastic iterative algorithms that involve sampling random variables. SA specifically refers to algorithms that solve route finding or optimization problems. Many other algorithms can also solve route finding and optimization problems, such as gradient-based methods. What are the advantages or characteristics of SA? It does not require knowing the expression of the objective function or its derivative. It may sound confusing at first, but you will soon understand how it works. The Robbins-Monroe algorithm, abbreviated as RM, is a pioneering work in the field of stochastic approximation. The widely used stochastic gradient descent algorithm is a special form of the RM algorithm. The mean estimation algorithm introduced earlier is also a special form of the RM algorithm. Now let's look at the problem and the algorithm. The problem is to solve this equation where W is the unknown variable and G is a function. For simplicity, we will consider the scalar case, where both W and G are scalars. Although this problem seems simple, it is very useful and widely exists. A typical example is optimization. For instance, to optimize an objective function JW, we usually solve this equation where the gradient of JW equals zero. This is a necessary condition for JW to reach a maximum or minimum. While it is not a sufficient condition, we can find local extremum in many cases. If JW has only one extremum, it becomes a sufficient condition. Such optimization problems can be written in the form of GW equals zero, where GW refers to the gradient. Additionally, we may need to solve GW equals C, where C is a constant. By moving C to the left side, we can get a new function GW minus C that equals zero, still fitting this form. In summary, this problem may seem simple but is very important. How do we solve the equation GW equals zero? There are two scenarios. The first scenario is when the expression of G is known. In this case, there are many methods to solve it. What we consider here is a very interesting scenario where we do not know the expression of the function G at all. You might wonder how we can solve it without knowing its expression. Think about neural networks, Y equals GW. The input is W and the output is Y. Essentially, it represents a function GW. A fully connected neural network can approximate a function, but we do not know its exact expression. So our goal is to find the input W that results in a zero output. This can be solved using the Robbins-Monroe algorithm. Let's now formally introduce the RM algorithm. The RM algorithm is an iterative algorithm. Our goal is to solve GW equals zero, and let's assume the optimal solution is W star. In this iterative algorithm, the kth estimate of W star is WK. The next estimate, WK plus 1, is calculated by combining WK and this term. This term consists of two parts, AK, a coefficient, and a function G tilde. The expression of G tilde is simple. It is GWK plus eta K, where eta K is noise. So what is G tilde? It is a noisy observation of G. In this algorithm, we treat the function GW as a black box. We do not know its expression. The algorithm requires the information of the sequence of inputs WK and the sequence of noisy output G tilde. Let's illustrate this with a diagram. There is a black box representing GW. When we input W, it outputs Y. However, we cannot accurately measure Y. There is noise, the value of which is unknown. What we can measure is G tilde. That is, we input W and get G tilde. Initially, we input W1 and get G tilde 1. We then use this to compute W2. Inputting W2 yields G tilde 2, which is then used to get W3, and so on. So we have a sequence WK and a sequence G tilde K. The RM algorithm solves the problem through this iterative process. Clearly, this reflects an idea. Without a model, we need data. Here, the model refers to the expression of the function. This is the same as the model-based and model-free reinforcement learning we introduced earlier. When we have a model, we do not need data. Without a model, we need data. In any case, we must have either. Earlier, we saw through an example that RM can find the solution. Now let us analyze why it can find this solution. That is to analyze the convergence of the RM algorithm. To do that, we will present two parts. In the first part, we will give another illustrative example to show why it converges, providing an intuitive explanation. In the second part, we will give a rigorous convergence analysis. Let's consider an example where the function GW equals this hyperbolic tangent function, and we need to find its root. We plot this function with W as the x-axis and GW as the y-axis. The curve of this function looks like this. Because it is a hyperbolic tangent function, it ranges from pi over 2 to negative pi over 2. The true root W star is at W equals 1. Now, we use the RM algorithm to solve this problem. The initial value of W is set to 3, so W1 equals 3, and AK equals 1 over K. For the sake of simplicity, we ignore the noise in this example. Therefore, the RM algorithm now directly uses GW without noise. Let's look at the results in this figure. You can see that at W1, we calculate GW1. The height of this point, when multiplied by a number, equals this segment. Then GW1 minus this segment jumps to W2. Calculating GW2 again and multiplying by a number gives the next segment. Then GW2 minus this segment jumps to W3, and so on until we reach W star. Through this example, it is clear that WK plus 1 is always closer to W star than WK. Why is that? Consider if this is W and this is W star. If WK is here and WK is greater than W star, then GWK is greater than 0. Subtracting a number from it means that WK plus 1 must be smaller than WK, making it closer to W star. If WK is smaller than W star, then GWK is less than 0. Subtracting a negative number is like adding a number, making WK plus 1 greater than WK, again making WK plus 1 closer to W star. This intuitive example shows why the RM algorithm converges. We can also look at this by plotting GW, with W as the input and Y, or GW as the output. The basic idea is to input W, observe the output, and if the output is greater than 0, then we decrease W slightly. The output decreases until it equals 0 and W stops changing. The key point here is how much to decrease W each time. The RM algorithm suggests subtracting AKG.